The Real McCoys, starring Walter Brennan, created by Irving Pincus.
Want you to meet the family known as the Real McCoys. That's Grandpappy Amos, the head of the clan. He roars like a lion, but he's gentle as a lamb. And now here's Luke, who beams with joy since he may take Mrs. Luke McCoy. From West Virginia, they came to stay in sunny California. Old Grandpappy Amos and the girls and the boys of the family known as the Real McCoys.
Say it's too late to be dropping in on people.
Rora, we got big news, and I want the McCoys to be the first to know it.
Well, I don't see why it can't wait till morning.
Ah, they are still up. The lights are still on.
I wonder who that is at this hour.
There might be one way to find out. Well, George, Florrie, come on
Hello.
In.
Hello.
Hi, George.
Amos, have I got news for you?
This is a dreadful time to come calling.
All right, all right.
What's up, George? Well, it really happened in the movies.
Oh, no, George, it really happened a long time ago. At least we started thinking about it a long time ago.
Yeah, my little sister's right again. But it really come to a head tonight at the movie.
All right, you go ahead and tell them.
Yeah. Well, Amos, on the silver screen, you see this fellow in a dugout. Floating down the Amazon River in South America. Then pretty soon you see the same fella riding a camel in the Gobi Desert. And before you know it, you see them, still the same fella, at the opera in Italy.
Well, now, it appears to me he done a lot of traveling just to hear some singing.
No, Amos, you don't get the point. You see, this picture made me realize that I ain't never been no place. Here I am, 65 years old, and what have I seen of the world? The valley here in Philadelphia.
I see what Mr. McMichael means. He wants to travel and see something of the world.
Boy, that sounds great, George.
What do you do, figure on taking a couple of weeks around the 4th of July?
Oh, no, Amos. We're going to travel for a couple of years, maybe more.
What?
In a nutshell, George McMichael Farmer is retiring from active service.
Retiring? You mean you're giving up the place?
Exactly. With the money we get from selling the farm, we can take care of ourselves nicely for the rest of our years.
Oh, George, you can't mean this.
I never mean anything more in my life, Amos.
George has worked long and hard. He deserves a rest.
Now, look, you pay me mine. Ollie, you pay me mine. You know what's going to happen to him? I'll tell you what's going to happen to him. He's going to get the heebie-jeebies of the nerves.
George isn't going to be sitting still. We're going to be traveling, seeing new places.
Yeah, well, worse yet. Supposing he gets the heebie-jeebies away over there in Egypt. They just wrap you up from head to toe and stick you in a box.
Boy, them ain't sick people. Them's mummies.
No matter what you say, Amos, we're selling out and we're going places. As the sun slowly sinks in the west, with a tear in his eye, George McMichael, world traveler, and his little sister Flora bid a fond adieu to exotic Pango Pango.
Yeah. With a good case of beery beery.
Hilda sent this lemonade out for you.
You drink it yourself, son. Lemonade ain't going to cure what ails me.
Cheer up, Grandpa. Everything will be all right. I'll argue and swap lies with you. I'll even play checkers with you. You won't even know Uncle George is gone.
Well, that's a right nice thought, little Luke, but it won't be the same. You're a bit young yet, boy. Come around and see me when you get to be a mean, ornery old man.
I'm sorry, Senor Grandpa. I didn't know you were out here.
You people got to learn to think on your feet. Where are you going with that cultivator?
To the McMichaels. Senorita Flora wants to scrape around the flower beds to make them look nicer. A buyer for the farm is coming.
Your customer coming already?
Well, if you're going to travel, I say, get going.
Give me that. I'll take it over my chef.
Oh, no. I was looking forward to a nice walk in the fresh air.
Well, the air over the back of that plow is just as fresh. Have some on me.
Yeah.
And you can see to this here tractor that all the mechanical equipment's been well taken care of.
Customers, huh? It might be a good idea to show them what kind of a neighbor Amos McCoy's going to make.
Uh-huh. Looks sound.
Oh, it is, it is. It's been delicately handled by a little old man who only used it to plow very soft fields.
Howdy, George. Howdy. I done brought over the cultivator the floor you wanted.
Oh, thanks, Amos. Oh, folks, I want you to meet my next-door neighbor and very best friend, Amos McCoy. Mr. and Mrs. Carl Tupper.
My pleasure. Mutual to you.
Delighted.
Right back at you. Folks figuring on buying this here dust bowl, are you? George, you're a little sensitive about jokes on agriculture. It's a fine farm.
We think so. Lovely place.
Having nice neighbors is one of our considerations.
Well, old Amos here's as fine a neighbor as a buddy'd want to know.
Gives me such a feeling of security to know that nice people are nearby.
My little lady is high-strung.
Well, George, you'll only hold up your salesmanship. Go right ahead.
Good idea, Amos. I get some more equipment here. You can see the discs are practically new, not a nick and a blade.
Are you all right, my dear?
Yes. I think we'd better go, though.
Go? Oh, I got a lot more to show you. Over here, Mr. Tupper. Just look at that trailer.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Looks sturdy enough. Lorraine, what's wrong with you, dear?
Nothing. I'd just like to go home.
What about the place? Wouldn't you like
we'll
to?
We'll let you know.
Well, honey, we...
I said we'll let you know. Come along, dear, please.
I'll call you later. What? I'll get you some warm milk.
My jingle, Amos. What do you make of that?
Well, he said she was high-strung.
Yeah, but they up and decide to go just like that. Beats me.
You know something, George? I had him spotted when he first set eyes on him. What you need, George, is to have me around to check these customers so you don't get slickered.
You know, Amos, selling this place ain't going to be too hard, and from now on, I'm going to be kind of choosy about who the buyer is.
Well, now, that's a good idea.
You might as well live next to somebody you like.
You know, George, if they was to bottle up your thoughtfulness, it'd be just like a tonic for the whole human race.
Amos, that's the deepest thing I ever heard.
Well, what is friends first?
The kitchen's equipped with all the latest conveniences.
Sure is.
Look at that stove. Uh-huh. And the refrigerator.
Yeah.
How about it, huh?
Yeah, everything looks fine to me. Sure does. Oh, just one thing I'd like to get clear in my mind is the boundary lines. Do you have a copy of the deed around?
Oh, sure, sure. I'll get it for you.
All right. Yeah, this sure is a nice place, Mr. McCoy.
Yeah, it sure is a nice place. You gotta give George credit, too. He works hard to keep it this way.
Uh-huh.
Now, you take this roof.
The roof?
Yeah, brand new. Puts on a new one every year.
That's incredible. Taking off an old roof and putting on a new one every year?
Oh, George, don't take it off his shaft. He has it took off for him, free. You see, being at the top of the hill here, he gets a full blast of the valley winds every November. Off goes the roof.
That's terrible.
Oh, it ain't so terrible. You see, the old roof all lands in small pieces in the backyard and makes George all set for kindling wood for the coming winter.
Well, I think I'll have a little glass of water.
Anything wrong?
Let me get you a good glass of water. I think I get rid of most of them.
But what was in there?
Well, go ahead, drink up. They're all gone.
But I want to know what was in there.
Well, I just can't say them scientific names.
I'm not thirsty.
Yeah, they're swimming around a lot easier now that it ain't so crowded in there.
Mr. McCoy, would you say goodbye to Mr. McMichael for me? I just remembered a very important appointment in town.
Well, it's a long, hot ride, and you better have a drink of water before you go.
Thanks.
Here's the deed, Miss Copley. It's got the boundaries where'd they go?
To town. He just up and took off, George. I guess he ain't interested in the place.
Well, that's funny. You know, Copley's the fourth one who just took off in the middle of things. You understand, Amish? You've seen it every time.
Yeah, real estate business is a funny business, George.
They all come in, they rave about how much they like the place, and zoom, there's a sudden changing of the minds. It's a mystery to me.
Maybe it's the wrong time of the year to sell real estate, George. Maybe you sort of put off your trip for a few months and then try it again in the fall, huh?
Yeah, maybe I'll have to do that if things don't happen pretty quick. My newspaper ad runs out tomorrow.
Well, now that makes sense.
Excuse me, Amish. Hello, George McMichael talking.
Howard Wolfson, Mr. McMichael. I have your ad here, and your place sounds exactly what I'm looking for. Can I come out and look it over this afternoon?
Oh, sure. I'll be here all day, Mr. Wolfson. 3 o'clock? Sounds fine. Yes. Goodbye, sir. Hot diggity, my place is just what this fellow wants.
Well, now, George, look, don't go to pasting those stickers on your satchel yet till I see what kind of a feller he is.
Well, now, Amos, maybe you shouldn't be in on this.
It ain't no trouble, George.
Oh, I appreciate your offer, Amos, but maybe I better handle him alone.
I won't be in the way.
Oh, I know that, Amos, but it's just that I don't want to miss out on this one. And, Amos, I may have to exaggerate on the finer points of the farm, and I wouldn't want to lie in front of an honest man like yourself.
Well, I don't mind if you lie a little.
No, you better not be here, Amos. I'd be embarrassed.
Yeah, George,
no, it's all right, Amos. Go ahead. I'll handle him. Goodbye, Amos.
Goodbye, George. Bon voyage.
Doing up at this hour? It's after midnight.
Oh, I just can't sleep, Luke.
Are you sick?
No, I ain't sick. Luke, he's just downright selfish. No concern for nobody. He just sells out, packs up, and moves out. Leaves it to shift for herself.
Well, what are you driving at?
Remember, Luke, 5 years ago when he first came out here?
Sure do.
Remember how I was ready to go back to West Virginia?
You had your heart set on it.
Something come up to change my mind and make me take up residence California style. Remember, Luke?
And you met up with George.
Nicest friend a man ever had.
So that's it, Grandpa.
So that's it, Grandpa. I'll tell you something else, Luke.
What?
George don't know any safe, but he gonna miss me too. You know, when he gets over there in Egypt and looks up at them big mummy hotels, he's gonna say, ain't that something, Amos? He's gonna look around, and I ain't gonna be there.
Well, I can't find no disagreement there.
Well, his mind is all filled up with that movie picture thing now, and his head is just inflamed with traveling, you see.
Sure is. Yeah, he's practically sitting between them camel humps.
Yeah, but you just give him a cooling off spell, and he'll change his mind. I know he will.
Grandpa, it's out of your hands now.
No, it ain't. And I ain't gonna take this laying down. And don't you forget, I give that man 5 of the best years of my life.
Care to join me at a tomato, Grandpa? They're mighty tasty.
No, not now, Luke. Maybe I'll meet you at the sink later.
Anybody home?
Oh, yes, we are.
Come on in, Floyd.
I'm putting things in order, and I wanted to return this casserole dish of Cade.
I put it away, Miss Flora.
Well, it won't be long now, Flory. You must be getting kind of excited.
Oh, so many things that have to be done in such a short time. We may be leaving any day.
Mighty quick.
George has just about made a sale with a Mr. Wolfson.
Flory, I can just see you zipping around that Ferris.
Everybody says it's breathtaking there.
Yeah. Who knows? You might even hook up with one of them Frenchmen.
Oh, they make very good husbands.
No. When I marry, I think I'll marry an American. I'd like to stay in my own backyard.
You know, Flory, I just don't bring anybody up here to this favorite spot of mine.
I'm flattered.
This is where me and little Luke sets the muskrat traps. And this is a special spot for a special occasion. Well, me and you has been rightly close for nigh on to 5 years now, ain't we?
We certainly have.
Folks on the outside have been linking us together by word of mouth. I think maybe it might be a good time to put a little proof in their pudding. You know, Flory, I'm going to ask you now, face to face and hand to hand, if you leave me be your lawful wedded husband.
Amos, this is so sudden, you've caught me completely by surprise.
You know, Flory, I think the three of us could be very happy together.
Three of us?
Sure, me and George and you.
What?
Well, George certainly ain't going to want to travel all by himself. And you want to be where your husband is.
Since George is the one you want to keep around, I suggest you propose to him.
Flory, you're the one I want. Flory, drink and live is cheaper. Wow!
Short traveler.
Unhook the door. I don't want the strong words you're going to say weakened by this screen strainer.
What's the trouble, George?
I just learned from the real estate man what you done to them people that wanted to buy my farm. Fishing stuff out of my drinking water and all that.
I don't know what you're talking about.
And there's something else I'm even madder about. You toying with my little sister's emotional affection. I didn't toy.
You did too, Toy? You toyed with malicious and selfish intent. All you thought about, Miss McCoy, was yourself.
Well, I can't deny that, George.
Oh, sufferings do you, Mr. McCoy. Because pretty soon, your old friend ain't going to be here to argue with you. And there'll be no one here to listen to them risky stories that you heard at the barbershop. And no one to play checkers with you.
I know that, George, but you'll be all right, though. You'll have Flory to play checkers with you.
Yeah, I can always... Flora don't play checkers.
That's right, but leastwise, she can argue with you.
Flora? Oh, she don't never raise her voice to no one. It's the kind of weakness she's got.
Leastwise, when it comes to them risque stories, we...
Flora's a lady.
That's right, George. Anyway, she'd be a good companion to you for more important things. Like when you get over to Egypt there and you're looking at them mummies and them cemeteries and all that stuff. Oh, you're in for a real exciting time, George.
Red or black?
Black. That's right.
Why, you miserable, low-down, ornery, mule-stealing chicken thief. You move.